look, we got Muslim sisters out here sitting right there. We got a Muslim sister right here. Go and ask her, right? She's sitting right there. Go and ask her. How does your husband treat you? How does your father treat you? How does your son treat you? How does Islam honor you as a Muslim woman, right?
Help me understand this. And I know there's probably a good reason behind it.
Go for it.
Why do they require it?
Excellent. Great question, right? When you look at the Bible itself, you find verses about hijab, the covering, right? Let me show it to you, right? But what happens is, in the Western society, they just don't do it anymore, right? They just left it. But in Islam, we stay true to it. We hold true to the word, right? 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 5 to 10 in the Bible, right? But every woman who prays or prophesies with her head uncovered dishonors her head. And that is one and the same as if her head to be shaved. For if a woman is not covered, let her head be sworn. But if it is shameful for a woman to have her head torn or shaved, let her be covered. Right? Now this is telling you to cover. But when is the last time you saw all these Christian women, who do you see covered? This is the New Testament. It's not even like talking about the Old Testament, right? What happens is Allah honors the woman to be known as modest women by being covered. Let's say you got a wife, right? You want some horny young dudes trying to, you know, pop a, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be real with you, bro. I'm not gonna sugarcoat this stuff, right? You don't want that. You're an honorable man. Exactly. It shows honor to the woman, and it does not make her a object of man's lust, and it protects a man from being tempted. Like now in America, what do we have? We have the highest rape rates in the world. We have the highest molestation rates. Go Google the stats, right? You don't see that in Muslim countries. Why? Because Muslim countries, we don't play like that. Our women are protected and honored. Our women honor themselves. Here what happens, they take women and they tell them, we're gonna liberate you. They mean we're gonna take your clothes off and we're gonna use you for marketing, right? And then what happens, you get these young guys that start to subjectify a woman as an object of sexual desire, right? So when you see a woman walking around Balboa Park with nothing but this and a little bit of this, you don't think about, I wonder how her personality is. You're trying to guess whether that's 36 D's or what, right? I'm gonna be real, so don't get offended, right? Right? This is what Islam stops. It honors that woman. It protects the man, right? That's why our women are covered.
How come you use the statement from the Bible to justify your statement?
Excellent, because Christians, they show us the Bible, and they tell us this is the words of God, and they say they live by this, and when we show them the same Bible, they deny it, right? So we as Muslims, we live by the Quran. The Quran tells us that the order of hijab in Surah Al-Ahzab is there so you can know this woman is an honorable woman. So she is protected, and then men are not tempted, right? That temptation begins with the look, right? You look at something, it begins the temptation. In Islam, when you see a woman covered up, you can't see her body, you can't see her figure, you can't even see her face. You have to now deal with her from her intellect, right? What she talks about, her intelligence is how you honor her. That's Islam for you.
Excuse me. I don't know.